Come on in. I want to show you something.
Don't.
I don't think I should feel.
Oh, I don't think you should either. That's why I'm just going to show you this one thing and kick you right out. Just give me 1 minute.
When he says he's going to show her this one thing and kick her out, he's just talking about his penis.
I was thinking that too. I didn't want to say it.
Yes, you did! Yes, you did!
Hello, and welcome to K&J Real Reacts. She's Kaija, I'm Joe, and today we are watching one of my all-time favorite movies, Groundhog Day. This movie is in my top 25 favorite movies of all time.
25 is such a vast number.
But the thing is, Kaija has never seen it. So no. My question for you, Kaija, what do you know about this movie?
I know that it follows a man. I'm thinking Billy Crystal. Is it Billy Crystal or is it Tom Hanks? I don't remember which one. On Groundhog Day, and I think it's like they keep doing something wrong. So they keep going back around and around and around. I think that's what it is. Am I correct?
Kind of, I would say. But yes, I didn't know if you knew like the Groundhog Day scenario of like living the same day over and over. All right, so now we know what she does and does not know about this movie, because neither Billy Crystal nor Tom Hanks is in this movie. So I can't wait to see Kaija's reaction as she watches this movie for the first time.
Am I going to like the main character? Like not the main character, but the person that plays the main character?
You might. You might not. We'll find out.
So non-committal.
All right, let's kick this off.
I'm ready. Oh, Bill Murray.
Out in California, they're going to have some warm weather tomorrow.
Is it controversial to say that my favorite Bill Murray role is when he played Bill Murray in
Zombieland?
Yeah.
Or Space Jam?
Zombieland.
Can we say that Zombieland and Space Jam are in the same universe? Because Bill Murray played Bill Murray in
both.
So I got that going for me, which is nice.
I'm assuming that Brian is... But I think you can related to Bill.
It's his older brother. You'll recognize him too. He's been in things.
I'm assuming that like he's probably like a bad person, quote unquote, in like real life, but then he has to like be a good person in order to project the next day.
Yeah, you can think that. Oh, do you know who Bill Murray's current girlfriend is?
No.
I'm blanking on her name, but it's the woman who sings
Colise?
Yeah. That is Bill Murray's current girlfriend.
Colise?
Yeah.
Yeah, the other guy was in another movie that I haven't seen. Home Alone.
What other guy?
The other guy that was standing there.
That was Chris Elliott. That's not Home Alone guy.
They look alike.
I mean, I can see that. That's just why I thought you thought they were the same guy. But no, they are not the same guy. We've been talking a lot, so to catch you up... He's been sent to cover the groundhog in Punxsutawney, and he doesn't really want to.
Because who would? Yeah, I'm your weatherman. Oh, that's why he's going, because he's the weatherman.
Yeah, you didn't catch him doing the weather at the opening of the movie?
It's nice. People like it.
What is Andie MacDowell doing in this movie? Like, what is her purpose?
She's the producer.
Okay, cool. Andie MacDowell has the most amazing hair. I swear to God. Is the camera guy like basically the help? He sets everything up. He drives. He does the video and audio.
Yeah. Pretty much.
Larry's just dropping me off. I booked in a very nice bed and breakfast in Cherry Street.
Great. You know, I think this is one of the traits of a really good producer.
I don't know if you guys can hear the clicking of his tongue with his lips. I do have you, Mr. Sunny.
Do you like this song?
It's okay. They're gonna, okay. Oh my god, they're gonna do it over and over and over again.
Yeah, that's the signal that it's a new day. So that was my question. If you don't like this song, you're in for a rough time.
Wait, you never said if I was your share.
Yeah, you're my share. We're gonna get divorced and then I'm gonna die in a skiing accident.
Never mind.
Yeah, that's the thing people forget. They got divorced.
Because it was more happy to think of them like married and working together and loving each other and da 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 da.
I hope you enjoyed the festivities.
Oh yeah, I'm sure I'm going to.
There's talk of a blizzard.
Well, we may catch a break and that blizzard's going to blow right by us. All of this moisture coming up out of the south by midday is probably going to push on
the super
Like, here's the thing, he's not a bad person, he's just rude.
Did you want to talk about the weather, or were you just making chit-chat?
He's so mean. Why become a weatherman if you don't want to talk about the weather to random people?
Do you have life insurance? Because if you do, you could always use a little more. Am I right? Right.
Ned, I would love to stand here and talk with you, but I'm not going to.
See you. Hey, that's all right.
I will say, though, this is the only interaction where his rudeness is, like...
warranted?
Yeah.
It is so good to see you. What are you doing for dinner?
Something else. Great seeing you, Needlehead.
You're missing all the fun. These people are great. Some of them have been partying all night long. They sing songs till they get too cold, and then they go sit by the fire, and they get warm, and then they come back, and they sing some more.
That's sweet.
Yeah.
They're if that's, like, the thing that you're into.
So, you sleep okay without me? You tossed and turned, didn't you?
You're incredible.
Who told you? You like your guys with the prominent upper teeth?
No.
You don't? Do you recognize the mayor?
He's first.
This February 2nd.
Brian Doyle-Murray.
In 30 seconds. Sorry, folks. 6 more weeks of winter.
Boo!
This is one time where television really fails to capture the true excitement of a large squirrel predicting the weather. I, for one, am very grateful to have been here.
Did you have, like, snowplow machines in Michigan? No, like, where you lived?
Yeah.
But you lived in the boonies, I don't
know. Yeah, the county had snowplows that they would come through and plow the roads in the winter.
What is he in a hurry to go back to the city for? Like, this big of a hurry. He's not even wearing his jacket.
Big blizzard moving in.
What blizzard? It's a couple of flakes.
Don't you listen to the weather. We got a major storm. Now you can go back to Punxsutawney, or you can go ahead and freeze to death.
What was so bad about Punxsutawney?
He's just a curmudgeon-y grump.
You two run along. Wow, looking foxy tonight, man. Hey, is your troop going to be selling cookies again this year?
I would wear that sweater. So it looks comfortable.
I think I'm going to go back to my room and take a hot shower and maybe read a little Hustler or something.
This is why you turn it on, wait, and then get in the shower. Especially when it's a shower that you don't want. Is he gonna do this the entire time, guys?
No, just this time.
Nice going, boys. You're playing yesterday's tape.
Deja vu, huh?
So the thing that has always confused me about, like, these kind of scripts is, does everybody go back? Or is it just, like, that person? In a sense of, like, how is he seeing the same things over and over and over again?
Just him. He's going back to them. It's the first day.
But, but are they going back? Or has he just gone back? Like, is he stuck in, like,
I think you're overthinking.
Purgatory? I can't unthink it. Please don't explain it to me.
Think of it like he's in a video game and it's just resetting every time.
I can't kill him. He'll just respawn at the last save point.
Will you be checking out today, Mr. Connors?
I'd say the chance of departure is 80%.
Gobbler's knob.
How would you feel if this was like you?
I would be freaking out.
Is this the first time they use this like plot device?
I think so.
Is that why it's called Groundhog Day?
Yeah.
We're up here at Gobbler's Knob, waiting for the forecast from the world's most famous groundhog.
Where is he from?
Punxsutawney Phil.
Bill Murray? Or the character?
Bill Murray.
Chicago.
Okay. That makes sense.
Ha! Oh my god!
How would you not know?
404. Why do you do that?
Because if the pencil's broken tomorrow, then that tells him something. But if the pencil's repaired tomorrow,
then it's gone back in time.
Yeah, this is when the panic sets in.
So how many times does it take for him to just beat the crap out of him?
Not very long.
Or punch him in the face.
Not very long.
We really.
Hey, it's a creative meeting. Forget it.
That's mean.
It's like yesterday never happened.
I am racking my brain, but I can't even begin to imagine why you'd make up something like this.
I'm not making it up. I am asking you for help.
How is she supposed to help you? I mean, honestly.
I don't know. Producer, come up with something.
Guys,
we better get going if we're going to stay ahead of the weather.
You're not.
Back in pits.
No plots.
I know him.
He's also the director of this movie.
Good job, my guy.
At least none that I can see, Mr.
Connors. Oh, wait, no, I thought he was somebody else. Just kidding. Just kidding.
You don't even know me.
You know what you may need, Mr. Connors?
A biopsy.
A psychiatrist.
Most of my work is with couples, families. I have an alcoholic now.
What does that have to do with him?
What would you do if you were stuck in one place? And every day was exactly the same, and nothing that you did mattered.
So life?
That about sums it up for me.
I mean, it's life, my guy.
That about sums it up for me.
They shouldn't be driving.
What are they going to do? Kill somebody and then they'll be alive at 6 a.m. tomorrow anyways.
He has a point.
But they don't know that it's Groundhog Day.
Hey, Phil, if we wanted to hit mailboxes, we could let Ralph drive.
Same
thing
now.
Your whole life. Clean up your room, stand up straight, pick up your feet, take it like command. Oh, yeah. Don't drive on the railroad track.
Well, Phil, that's one I happen to agree with.
I'm betting he's going to swerve first.
Did this happen because he's drunk and Groundhog Day, or just because of Groundhog Day?
I think probably mostly Groundhog, like 90% Groundhog Day, 10% drunk.
Two large fries, two chocolate shakes.
I would like a milkshake and a cheeseburger and some French fries.
Now is not the time.
How many times do they play the song?
Every time.
I'm saying how many times?
I don't know. Because now he lives in a world without rules, so he can do whatever he wants, so he's about to have fun.
Will you hold my room for me, please? I'm going to stay an extra day.
That's assault, sir.
You did.
That's assault.
Phil? Phil?
Hey, yeah, he's the most Phil annoying Connors, portion of man. This entire movie. I was right.
That's our assault. No, this is assault.
No! Why didn't you tell him? That wasn't nice.
I like to see a man of advancing years throwing caution to the wind. It's inspiring in a way.
Advancing years.
That is horrifying. Horrifying.
The wretch concentred all in self. The vile dust from whence he sprung. Unwept, unhonored, and unsung. Sir Walter Scott.
Like Michael Scott?
Would you want to do it on Groundhog Day?
No. No. I celebrate privately.
You think I'm acting like this because I'm egocentric?
I know you're egocentric. It's your defining characteristic. Well, would you like a doggy bag?
No, I'm going to stay here and finish.
I think the biggest travesty of this entire movie so far is that he didn't even finish the bacon. He didn't even eat the bacon.
Yeah.
Hey, did you see the groundhog this morning?
Uh-huh. I never miss it.
What's your name?
Nancy Taylor.
What high school did you go to?
What?
High school.
Lincoln.
Oh, my gosh.
Who are you?
Oh, my gosh.
Okay. Thanks very much.
Hey. Hey.
Despicable.
Nancy Taylor. Lincoln High School.
You don't remember me, do you?
I even asked you to the prom.
Please have a seat.
Listen, I gotta go do this report.
Are you a reporter?
I'm a weatherman with Channel 9 Pittsburgh.
Wow, gosh, I should have known. That's great.
But maybe later we could...
Yeah, whatever.
Oh my gosh. I only know one person from Chicago. And he's a good guy. He would probably do this too, though. He would probably do this.
Oh, Phil.
Oh, Rita.
Who's Rita?
How should I know?
Who is Rita?
And Andie MacDowell.
I love you. I've always loved you.
What is going on?
He's trash.
What do you mean, what's going on?
What is going on?
He's making out with a woman and he accidentally said his co-worker's name.
No, I know that. Why did he say, oh, yo, you marry me? She was like, yeah, 1 million right now. Right? What are we doing?
She wanted a bone.
Not so bright look on your face.
So basically he's just doing stuff now just to like right, prove Doris, that he can go. Do it.
Yeah.
Hey, they gave him a tan. They put bronzer on his face so he looked more tan.
Hiya, Nancy. Fiance. I didn't remember.
Hi.
That would be so weird if someone just was walking down the street and they were like, oh, hey, Kaija. I'm like, who are you? Yeah. I don't know you.
Are you seeing anyone?
I think this is getting too personal. I don't think I'm ready to share this with you. How about you? What do you want?
What I really want is someone like you.
Oh, please.
What are you looking for? Who is your perfect guy?
Not you.
Well, first
don't
of all,
tell him.
I'm humble to know he's perfect.
That's me.
He's intelligent, supportive, funny.
Me.
He's romantic and courageous.
Me also.
He's got a good body, but he doesn't have to look in the mirror every 2 minutes. Oh, and he plays an instrument, and he loves his mother.
I am really close on this one.
Was that, like, important besides the fact that he took out an important part of the car?
Not really. He took it out so that way he doesn't
have to make an excuse not to go back.
The van won't start, so now they're just stuck there and he gets to hang out with her while Larry works on the car. For you, miss?
Sweet vermouth. That's not the things that she asked for. Yeah, that is not kind. That is not caring. That is not anything that she asked for.
What are the chances of getting out of town today?
The van still won't start.
Oh my gosh, he's just grabbing intel so he can use later down the road. My gosh, okay. Men are diabolical.
Can I buy you a drink?
Okay.
Sweet vermouth rocks with a twist, please.
For you, miss?
The same. That's my favorite drink.
Mine too.
He is an evil, evil man.
How do you know so much about Punxsutawney?
I spend a lot of time here. At high altitude. That's where I see myself in 5 years. How about you?
Oh, I agree. I just like to go with the flow. See where it leads me.
So what's going to happen in like a week? Of course it's about a million when he doesn't answer all the questions correctly?
You weren't in broad. How about you?
Oh, I agree. I just like to go with the flow.
Yeah?
See what happens.
Well, it's gotten you here.
Uh-huh.
This is not fair. This is so not fair at all.
Oh, yeah?
Believe it or not, I studied 19th century French poetry.
La fille qui j'aimerais I hope that one day I could do this with my own children.
Dude, you're 40.
More like 50.
At least it's Ray Charles.
See, he's learning to be nice.
No, he's not. He's learning to use the words that she says to come off as, like, attractive to her. Like, it's gross. It's so gross. It's gross.
I mean, yeah. What?
I'm just amazed.
Andie, he does not deserve to have one strand of your dead hair in his shower.
Come on in, I want to show you something.
Don't.
I don't think I should feel.
Oh, I don't think you should either. That's why I'm just going to show you this one thing and kick you right out. Just give me 1 minute.
When he says he's going to show her this one thing and kick her out, he's just talking about his penis.
I was thinking that too. I didn't want to say it.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did.
Maybe I should go.
Where would you go?
To her hotel. Can I say, Joe, the fact that your favorite movie or one of your top 25 favorite movies has a literal rape scene, it is a kerfuffle. Andie Lee.
Oh no, I can't believe I fell for this.
Yeah.
This whole day has just been one long setup.
No, yeah. It hasn't.
And I could never love someone like you, Phil, because you'll never love anyone but yourself.
That's not true. I don't even like myself.
Maybe the lesson is to not do any of this stuff. Like, he is manic right now.
Yeah, like, it's falling apart.
She is afraid.
Like, he's going through the motions at this point. It's not, like, a real thing anymore.
But it was never a real thing.
But, like,
that's
he
the
was...
whole thing. It was never real.
But, like, it's become more of, like, memorization than actual, like, doing things. Where, like, the first time, at least he was, like, learning and doing things. Now it's purely just going through the motions.
But
so
it's
he's
not
getting caught.
Ever good because he's learning for an ulterior motive.
No, you're not wrong. I'm not saying you're wrong.
It wasn't like he actually wanted to get to know her. He wanted to get to know her enough so he could have sex with her.
His South American lake drains into the smaller
lake. What is Titicaca?
Bolivia. Jim.
What is Titicaca?
Correct.
Lakes and rivers for 1,000.
Milky colored from glacial clay when entering Lake Geneva, this river is clear blue upon exiting.
You should be frightened, Jan.
He's having a rough time.
I don't care. I don't like him.
Bill Murray sucks, man.
As long as this groundhog keeps seeing his shadow, I don't see any other way out. He's got to be stopped.
Real good, Phil.
What is he going to do?
Real good.
I'm worried. I think there's something really wrong with Phil.
Yeah, there's a lot of things really wrong with Phil.
True life.
I just want you to remember we had a beautiful day together.
Oh, is he gonna, like, unalive himself or something?
I think he's trying to get out of it at this point.
Hey! Hey, what are you doing?
Hey! Hey, get the word out! Somebody kidnapped Phil! We're going after him!
Why would anybody steal a ground?
I could probably think of a couple of reasons. Pervert.
You gotta shoot. Aim high. I don't want to hit the groundhog.
Wait, that's his brother, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's his buddy. Then.
It's shot on me, Larry, in three.
Did you get hit, Larry?
One. Don, parcel fly. Parcel fly.
What are you going to do?
I'm nuts.
What did he think was gonna happen? Like he was gonna actually die?
Yeah, he hoped, probably.
Did you sleep well, Mr. Connors?
Would
you this is a montage of trying not to waste any more time.
Oh my god.
But he does. He doesn't care about people. Never mind. I was going to say, like, you do understand that everybody that has to deal with your death after your death, like, it's going to mentally fuck them up, especially if it's not their job to
for
like,
a
deal
day,
with that kind of
and
stuff.
Then
but I'm saying
that was clearly not Bill Murray, but
I understand, but it's like it's just so screwed up.
He was a really, really great guy.
He was a guy.
I'm sorry, what was that again?
I'm a god.
You're a god.
I'm a god. I'm not the god.
Because you survived a car wreck?
I have been stabbed, shot, poisoned, frozen, hung, electrocuted, and burned.
Oh, really?
Fuck the Rasputin, this guy.
How do you know I'm not a god?
Oh,
because you're a person.
It's not possible.
Doris, this is Doris. Her brother-in-law, Carl, owns this diner. She's worked here since she was 17. More than anything else in her life, she wants to see Paris before she dies.
Oh, boy, what I...
This is Debbie Kleiser and her fiancé, Fred.
You might recognize Fred.
They're supposed to be getting married this afternoon, but Debbie is having second thoughts.
What?
Fred comes back.
He likes the town, he paints toy soldiers, and he's gay.
I am.
And her?
Nancy, she... works in the dress shop and makes noises like a chipmunk when she gets real excited.
Hey.
It's true.
How do you know these people?
You like boats, but not the ocean. You go to a lake in the summer with your family up in the mountains.
This is not endearing.
A dock and a boathouse.
Is this supposed to be endearing?
I don't know.
In a place
you do.
You're a sucker for French poetry.
I'm supposed to be endeared to him because he listened to her.
You're very generous.
The bar is so low.
When you stand in this.
Maybe it really is happening. I mean, how else could you know so much?
Well, there is no way. I'm not that smart.
Is this what you do with eternity?
Now you know. That's not the worst part.
What's the worst part?
The worst part is that tomorrow you will have forgotten all about this, and you'll treat me like a jerk again.
No.
Because you are a jerk.
It's all right. I am a jerk.
Thank you for understanding. No. Guys, this is supposed to be endearing. When we know he tried to...
You're still here.
...have non-consensual sex with him. Oh, with her.
I thought you were supposed to disappear, or I was, or something.
Not until six.
Oh, you rat!
You should leave. Just like that Dan and Shay song. You should probably go to bed.
At least he didn't use any tricks this time. He didn't.
Wow. He was a semi-decent person. Everything is forgiven.
I think you're the kindest, sweetest, prettiest person I've ever met in my life. I've never seen anyone that's nicer to people than you are.
See, this is more endearing because she's asleep. He doesn't know that if she can hear him or not. This is what he should have been doing the entire time, which is why at 6 o'clock, it's not going to be the same day as it was before. Unless I'm wrong. And he still did something to mess the entire situation up.
I don't deserve someone like you.
I'm not going to argue.
Did you say something?
Is that me?
You're the Andie MacDowell to my Bill Murray.
Oh, damn. Give him some money, dude. Had he not ever done that before?
Hmm.
He's not getting that money back.
If you had to guess, like, throughout this whole process, how many years, like, does he live through? Days of years? What would you guess?
800, because that's how long it would take for him to become a better person.
the generally agreed upon thing is 10,000 years worth of days.
Yeah. Let's go for
it. My God.
That's the thing too of like you're like somewhat of a spoiler that he eventually gets out of it,
of course.
But like you wouldn't even remember your life before. Like,
no,
you, like
this would be your life. This would be your whole life.
You get out of it, and then you wouldn't even like, where's my ad? What apart? What does my apartment even look like? Like,
literally.
Where did I leave my keys? Like,
literally. I like those lampshades though. Those are very nice.
Yes, I'd like a piano lesson, please.
Oh, okay. I'm with a student now, but if you want to come back tomorrow, I can probably...
Well, I kind of want to get started. I could give you $1,000.
Cut it.
Same, lady. Same. Oh, a child? It's a beautiful piano.
Not bad. Mr. Connors, you say this is your first lesson?
Yes, but my father was a piano mover, so... Let's get you someplace warm. Yeah. Yeah. Remember me?
Are you the one who brought the old man in?
Mm-hmm. How's he?
Well, he just passed away.
What did he die of?
He was just old. It was just his time.
He's like, I'm older.
Where's the chart?
Sometimes people just die.
That is true, unfortunately. What does he think he's gonna do? Go back and save him? Oh, because he's hungry, I'm sure.
Because he probably feels like he's been able to not die today. And so he's like, it's not fair that this guy, he's realized this guy has died every day.
Well, that's horrifying. That's horrifying. That's so horrifying.
Come on, Pop. Come on, Pop.
It's like, look, he's like giving him mouth to mouth where like in the past he didn't even give him a fucking dollar.
Well, where are you going? Would you like to get a cup of coffee?
I'd love to. Can I have a rain check? I've got some errands I've got to run. Okay?
Errands in a town?
Bill! Errands? What errands?
Exactly.
I thought we were going back.
What do you say? You little brat. You have never thanked me. I'll see you tomorrow. Maybe.
So basically, has to save everybody else. Save everybody else.
You live in Pennsylvania.
Oh my God, he is having a heart attack. Do something.
What can I do?
Call 411.
Mom, I don't think he's breathing.
Doctor, anything. Mom. Oh my God.
It's hard to do the Heimlich.
He's probably had a lot of practice.
Fair.
You know, I think that most people just think that I hold the camera and point it at stuff.
Please don't turn into a weird guy. I was on your team.
Would you be at all interested in seeing the inside of the van?
Ooh, spoke too soon.
Let me just drop a tip.
Please don't. Okay. Do you leave $2?
Did you see what he did?
No.
He left $2 when she was looking, and then Rita, when she turned around, he took one of the dollars back. See, Rita?
We were just he didn't even leave.
Gonna go?
Yeah. Never mind, I don't like him either. Never mind. No, none of them. None of them.
No, he's playing the piano?
Him. Exactly. Yeah. And your ugly ass sweater.
You liked his sweater.
That was before he was a creep. Who stiffed service workers. Is Bill Murray actually not?
You know how many times they've shown his hands touching the piano? Zero times.
I wasn't really looking. Just vibing. Oh, his hands.
Yeah, where's Bill Murray's face?
Right there.
Hello, welcome to our party.
Bill, I didn't know you could play like that.
Oh, I'm versatile.
Okay, I understand he has gotten better, but like, also, like, he's still... took the things that she said before and is using them as a guide on how to be a decent person in order to make her like him.
To me, I look at more as like he accidentally became, he just like, because she inspired him to be a good person because of that whole speech where he's talking to her. And he's like, oh, she's like one of the kindest people I know, blah, blah, blah. And I think he kind of accidentally became the right person.
Excuse me, Mr. Connors.
Hey, see, Fred. That's Fred. You might recognize
oh,
him.
Oh, hey!
You're making Debbie go through with it and everything.
Making Debbie go through with it.
No. WrestleMania! No way! No way!
You guys aren't going.
Thank you, Mr. Connors. You're a real pal.
Oh, this is the best.
Time for the big bachelor auction. Now you all know the rules. All the eligible bachelors come down in front. And you ladies, you bid on them. And you get to do whatever you want with them. No questions asked. I don't know about it as long as it's legal.
Wait, so is there like a fan theory that all of Bill Murray's trash qualities transferred onto the cameraman?
No.
Because that's what my theories are. Like, that's what my theory is.
There is another theory about somebody else.
$5!
The bidding has begun at $5. Do I hear more?
I'm sorry. Him?
Yeah.
That.
$339.88.
What is the charity?
Yeah.
Okay, bachelors, who's next?
Me. Nobody's gonna bid for you.
Oh, somebody buys him.
One of the older ladies?
Oh, shoot. Two bids.
Sold, little lady, for 25 cents.
Ooh.
Phil Connors, I thought that was you.
Rita, this is Ned Ryerson. He's my new insurance agent.
I'll say. I have not seen this guy for 20 years. He comes up to me and then he buys whole life term, Uniflex, fire, theft, auto, dental, health, with the optional death and dismemberment plan, water damage. Phil, this is the best day of my life.
Mine too.
Mine too.
Where are we going?
Yours? Oh, why is it the best day of her life?
Why can't I look?
Because you bother me a lot.
I'm getting cold. How much longer do I have to sit here?
I'm just trying to give you your money's worth. You paid top dollar for me.
Well, I think you were a bargain.
To do what? Sweetie, you gave him all your money.
Is it finished yet?
Almost. I still have to put some cherry syrup on the top and then we can eat it. One second. All right. Well, let me turn in the light.
It's amazing. It's beautiful.
I know your face so well, I could have done it with my eyes closed.
Then why did you have to stay out in the cold?
I'm happy now. Because I love you.
I think I'm happy too.
Didn't 8,000 years ago she say that he didn't know her, so why are you saying that you love me? And it's the same day in her timeline.
Because he's not using tricks. It's not about him just knowing things about her anymore.
But, like, she doesn't know that he did that. She doesn't know.
It's a movie.
Okay. You just can't show me a movie, like, literally about a trash man. And I'm like, oh my god, he's so sweet. He falls in love with the amazing, illustrious Andie MacDowell. He deserves her. Even after 10,000 years.
The song played again.
But it's not the same day. She's in bed with him because they're not paying off her.
That is a great song. No, it's not. Don't listen to this man.
What did I say? I know things.
What would give you a bigger existential crisis? The first couple times that happens or the first time it didn't happen after 10,000 years?
That time.
Because you wouldn't believe it, I don't think.
Yeah, like you were saying, I think this would be the crazier thing to happen if I was him.
I gotta check some. Oh, stay.
They're gone!
They're all gone.
I feel like after her being in your bed, like,
you know what today is?
10,000 years.
I got it. It's kind of like that movie, Palm Springs.
Yeah.
Where he ends up taking her on his rotation with him.
It was the end of a very long day.
It'd be really funny if it was like, oh, wait, no, we messed up. Let's go back. So what was different?
I think because he's happy.
His happiness took him out of the constant rotation.
Yeah, he was happy. And you know how he became happy? So
by being with her?
By being a good person.
Let's live here.
I'm gonna begin and end this movie on the comment that Andie MacDowell's hair for the last however many years has been amazing perfection.
All right, so what did you think of Groundhog Day?
I love Andie MacDowell.
Mm-hmm.
That's, and I mean, honestly, 1,000,000%, I love Bill Murray. Did I love Phil? No.
Yeah.
He wasn't my fave. I swear I've seen that guy in other, like, movies.
The guy you've seen before, is that the insurance salesman?
No, I'm talking about the guy that was their camera guy. Yeah.
Is this a movie you'd watch again?
If you asked me to, I would. Would I go out on my way to watch it? Probably not. But also, as you could tell, Bill Murray is a great actor because he was mildly infuriating in this entire movie. Even in the end, I was kind of like, does he deserve to go back and back and back and forth on the same day over and over again for 1,000 years or 1,000 days? No, nobody does. Nobody deserves that. But he was using his lack of repercussions to his advantage in a way that I did not appreciate.
Yeah.
I mean, like I said, Andie MacDowell, 10 out of 10, would always recommend. There were some, you know, people that in there that I knew well from other movies, from other TV shows, from other things. It was great. Yeah. I liked it. It was cute. I would watch it again.
So there's, can you guess? I told you during the movie that there's a fan theory.
Mm-hmm.
Regarding this movie, can you guess what that fan theory might be?
You said it was in regards to something that I said.
No, because
you said about, because I was like, did all the bad things about Bill Murray's character transfer into the other guy? And you were like, no, but there is another fan theory about that.
No, there's another fan theory about this movie, but it has nothing to do with that guy.
Oh, can you give me like a roundabout about it?
It's about another character in this movie. Like, you could do another movie, a similar movie about another character in this movie.
The old guy that dies. Oh, the insurance salesman.
The big fan theory regarding this movie is the insurance salesman was also in a Groundhog Day scenario, and he happened to intersect Phil Connors on a day. So like, he wasn't like aware that Phil Connors was different or anything, but he was living the same day over and over, and just like the one day happened to be the same day as Phil Connors. And that's why Phil, like, the similar situation like he did with Nancy, where like he said all these things that like made sense to Nancy, but obviously she didn't know him, where he's like, oh, Phil Connors, remember me from high school, blah 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 blah. And then the first time Phil's like, yeah, I don't remember you at all. And so there's a theory that Ned Ryerson was living a Groundhog Day scenario as well.
But he was doing the same thing, so we never learned a lesson.
But because it was only one of his days, if that makes sense. So, like,
okay,
their days, if you look at it as, like, two separate circles that happen to intersect, where he was living the same day over and over and over, but that was only one of...
their Venn diagrams.
Yeah.
And the middle.
Okay. Yeah, so it wasn't like they were both waking up together, if that makes sense. It was more like...
Yeah. No, I get it. I understand what you're saying. I can see how that would be a fan theory because, I mean, he was kind of acting like he knew more than Bill Murray.
Yeah.
Bill Murray's character remembered, but also it was very much indicative of, like, Bill Murray's character doesn't really care about anybody. Mm. So that's why he would not remember some guy that he went to school with. But it was also kind of weird. I remember thinking in the movie, like, how did he know him?
Yeah.
But didn't he say they went to school together?
Yeah. Well, that's also what Bill Murray said to Nancy Taylor.
Exactly. So, I don't know. It was just very peculiar. I don't know. But that makes sense.
And then, obviously, another thing they never touch on in the movie is how the Groundhog Day scenario starts.
Yeah.
There's, like, a deleted scene or a scene that was, like, in the script that never got filmed.
Yeah.
Where an ex-girlfriend of Phil's sees him on TV.
Yeah.
And it's, like, he had wronged her, so she put a curse on him.
To start it.
To, like, kickstart it. But they felt...
Until he became a better person.
Yeah, but they felt like it wasn't needed, so they just took it out.
I mean, yeah, I didn't really think about, like, why it was a thing that was happening.
All right. Anything else you want to say about Groundhog Day?
No. It was good. I liked it.
All right. Without further ado, goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.